Right, let's see the next feature of microcontroller, which is timers and counters from microcontroller. So 8051 is supporting the six standard features, which is memories and I/O ports. The importance of each block, which is already clear, the memories, RAM memory used for data storage and ROM memory used for program storage, and I/O ports are used for external peripheral interfaces. So coming to the next block, which they are saying timers slash counters. The name itself, you need to understand the importance of these timers. Timers' purpose is very clear from microcontrollers. They allows to generate accurate time periods, depends on application. See, from I/O ports onwards, you need to observe the purpose of blocks or purpose of features towards applications. So timers are used to generate accurate time delays, depends on application requirement. So if you observe the regular clock, the functionality of your regular clock, which is having seconds needle, minutes needle and hours needle. The seconds needle, which is keep on counting seconds, starts with 1 and ends with 60. So means depends on the counting process, the hours are calculated or minutes are calculated. Okay, so once your second schedule is starting count from 1 to 60, your 1 minute time is over. Means to get your 1 minute time, you are counting 60 seconds. If you are looking for 2 minutes, what is your process to count? Yours. There is no count of 61, 62, 63, 64. So 1 to 60, which is repeated 2 times. So based on this, you are looking to count the seconds by using regular clock. The same thing which is done by your microcontroller timers, they are providing time for us just by the clock cycles counting process. So how many clock cycles they can count and what is the duration of each clock, that you need to understand from the timers. The microcontroller timers names are T0 and T1. So these are two 16-bit timers from 8051 microcontroller. So they are measuring the capacity of timers again in the form of bit here. So what is meant by 16-bit timer now? So 16-bit timer means it can count cycles 2 power 16 pulses for one rotation. So 2 power 16 equivalent value is 65,536. Means if you begin with count, so there is no 1 here, you're always your counting starts from 0 now. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this count, which is up to 65,535, means whenever you are dealing with the 16-bit timers, they may be count to 2 power 16 pulses for one rotation, and the counting starts from 0 and ends with 65,535. And what is the duration of each count? Like a regular clock also giving the exact time delay between each count, which is 1 second. Between 1 to 2, there is exact time period 1 second. Between 2 to 3 also, there is exact 1 second time period. The same way, your microcontroller timers are also giving fixed time delay between each count. Further, the formula is pulse period 12 divided by the crystal oscillator frequency. So based on the connected oscillator across 18 and 19 pins from the microcontroller, so the pulse period decides. So now, as per our reset circuit, the working frequency for your 8051 is 11.0592 MHz. So as per this, if you cancel this, so this will become microsecond, and 12 divided by 11.0592 is approximately 1.0852. Means If you are counting one pulse by using timer, the exact time delay between each count is 1.0852 microsecond. Between each count, the period is very clear, which is 1.0852. As per this, based on your requirement, you may be looking for milliseconds, you may be looking for microseconds, you may be looking for minutes. You need to count number of pulses by using timers. Like how I am looking for 2 minutes, I am doing 2 rotations here. And 3 minutes, 3 rotations. However, I am doing 360 times. So like this, based on my requirement time delay, I need to count this number of pulses by using timers. But the maximum capacity of timer is for one rotation depends on the capacity of timer. 8051 is supporting two 16-bit timers, which is T0 and T1. For example, I am looking for 250 microseconds time delay. So for 250 microseconds time delay, how many pulses I need to count? So the formula is number of pulses is equal to required time delay divided by a constant time delay. So this is the mathematical part which is required for timers always. So as a programmer, you need to know about what is the exact pulse period I'm getting for each count and how many pulses I need to count to for required time delay. So required time delay is 250 microseconds now, and the constant time delay of each pulse, which is 1.0852 according to my crystal frequency. Suppose if I am changing this crystal frequency to other one, like 12 MHz or 24 MHz, the pulse duration is going to change. So now as per this, the pulse period is 1.0852 microsecond. So if you cancel 250 divided by 1.0852, so mostly you need the help of calculator. So for this, you are just looking for some 230 or 230 pulses required for timers approximately. So now how to count these 230 pulses by using this timer? Mostly if you start with 0, the timer, it is not possible to stop at any middle point. Like you cannot stop your timer at 100, or you cannot stop timer at 200 or 230 or 240. So that is the reason you need one calculation, which is initial values. So this calculation is also required. The three things you need to know before proceeding timer's programming. The first one is pulse period. The pulse period I am calculating based on my working frequency of oscillator. And the number of pulses I am calculating based on the required time delay divided by a constant time delay. And the third one, initial values. The initial value means your timer is not able to stop at any middle point. Only timer you can stop just by reaching maximum value. Means if you start with 0, there is no chance to stop timer at any middle point. Like 5000, 6000 or 10000 or 20000. So that you need to calculate the initial value also. So what is meant by initial value here, and how to find this initial value? The initial value is very clear: maximum value minus required number of pulses. So what is my maximum value according to this? 65535. And how many number of pulses I got? 230. So if I am subtracting this, I will get 65,305. So this is my initial value. Means I need to start at 65,305. From here to 65,535, if I count, I am able to count 230 pulses. So this will be the initial value. So not is 0 in this case. So this initial value you need to load with a specific registers, which is TH and TL. So this initial value calculation is required for timers. Based on your number of pulses, we are able to calculate initial value also. So you will go for a few examples, like looking for time delay, looking for time delay and looking for number of pulses based on required time delay. So you will proceed with different values. So now I will show you. So looking for 500 milliseconds time delay. So how to generate this 500 milliseconds time delay? For this, you are able to calculate three things. The first one is pulse period, and second thing is number of pulses, and third one is initial value and number of repetitions. So these three things are mandatory for any time delay using timers. Now looking for 500 milliseconds and working oscillator frequency, you need to compulsory consider this frequency, because this will decide the pulse period. If you are working with other frequencies, the pulse period is going to change as per formula. Now 500 milliseconds, what is my pulse period? So first thing is pulse period. The pulse period formula is 12 divided by 11.0592. This is megahertz. So you will get 1.0852 microsecond. The second calculation is number of pulses. So number of pulses formula, which is required time delay divided by pulse period. So what is my required time delay? 500 milliseconds. And pulse period is 1.0852 microsecond. So don't cancel directly. So now you need to use calculator for number of pulses. 500. Then how to convert into milliseconds into microseconds? Just with three zeros, microseconds divided by 1.0852 microseconds. So I'm just doing calculation for this. So I got 460,744.563. But your timer is not able to calculate these point values. Always the count is in integer form. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So whenever you have calculations on points, you need to take it the next value if it is more than 0.5. So now my required pulses are 460,745 pulses. So using timer, I need to count this 460,745 pulses. But according to this timer capacity, the timer is capable of counting 65,536 cycles or pulses for one rotation. But now requirement is 460,745 pulses. Then from where to start to count these 460,745 pulses and how many rotations I need to do. So for that, the initial value is very important. The initial value calculation is, but now I got the number of pulses is more than what timer is capable of counting. Whenever you are looking for more pulses than maximum value, so you need to do number of rotations. Now just approximately, I am just taking this division, the 460,745, if I am dividing with some 8 or 7, which is comes under less than 65,535. You have to take this initial value, which is always less than 65,535. Your timer is not capable of counting more than 65,535. Or else, you can directly divide these 460,745 with 65,535 maximum value. So I am just taking 460,745 divisible with 65,535. So you get 7.03. So again, this is more than 7 which is coming. So I will proceed with 4,60,745 divided with 8. So I got 57,593. So my combination is 57,593 into 8. So I'm counting 57,593 pulses 8 times. So I got 4,60,744 pulses. So this multiplication, you have to take it very close to your required pulses always. Now I'm counting 57,593 pulses 8 times. But to count these 57,593, you cannot start at 0, because there is no chance to stop a timer at 57,592. So that my initial value is maximum value minus the number of pulses for one cycle. So 65,535 minus 57,593. So again, I am using calculator, which is 65,535 minus 57,593. This is 7942. See, I'm just giving the diagram, which is easy to understand. This is my initial value and this is my maximum value. Initial value is 0 and maximum value is 65,535. I'm not beginning with 0. Now I'm going to start from 7942 and counting up to 65,535, so that how many pulses I'm able to count? 57,500. This whole process I am repeating 8 times. By taking one loop concept, you can repeat your 57,593 pulses 8 times. So once you are doing this 57,593 pulses 8 times, you are counting 4,60,744 pulses. This is how you can generate time delays by using timers. You can take any time delay. These calculations are mandatory. The first calculation is pulse period, and second calculation is number of pulses, and third calculation is initial value. So this is my initial value. Maybe the initial value is changing according to your required pulses, and this is number of times repetition. So, but the timer capacity is fixed always, which is 0 to 65,535. If the next level microcontrollers are having the higher capacity, like 32 bit, then your timer capacity, which is changing from 0 to 2 power 32 minus 1. So that is the way to deal with the timers. The timers are able to generate accurate time delays, depends on your requirement. But if you are looking for accurate time delays, this calculation is mandatory. So first calculation is pulse period, and second calculation is number of pulses, and third calculation is initial values. So if you are filling this diagram, so this is 0 to 65,535 is the maximum capacity. The one is initial value. The initial value may be 0 or any other value. And this is your required pulses. And this may be number of times repetition, maybe one time or two times or three times. This is how you can use timers for time delays in applications. If you are looking for 1 second or 1 minute or 2 minutes or any time delay you are looking, you can generate by using timers. But remember, the pulse source for your timers is always crystal oscillator. That is the only reason you are trying to consider the crystal frequency whenever I am dealing with timers. So this is how you can generate accurate time delays for applications. So for more videos, please subscribe Aerotech Solutions from YouTube. We will proceed with the next topics, counters and other applications. Thanks for watching.